मॉर्निंग आई थॉट इट्स नॉट पॉसिबल, हेवी रेन विंड एंड विंड इज ब्लोइंग नॉट लेस देन 80 किलोमीटर्स पर आवर, सो वी थॉट पावर ऑफ मोबाइल स्विच ऑफ, देर वॉज नो पावर विथ मोबाइल फोन राइट, सो आई थॉट इट्स नॉट पॉसिबल, सो इमीडिएटली आई कॉल्ड यू मैम एक्चुअली दिस इज हैपनिंग.
Bridges sir, should I start?
Yes.
Okay sir.
Again, power failure, ma'am. Wait 1 minute. I need to go outside. Today morning, starting from morning, actually, these things are happening.
Hello.
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Welcome everyone. Thank you for joining us for today's webinar. My name is Vishaka Khambati and I am the faculty of Biomedical Engineering Department at PITTS Parul University. Today we are presenting a webinar on Innovation Transforming India, which is presented by Professor Ramesh Chandra Panda. Currently he is working as a Dean of Research and Development at Synergy Institute of Engineering and Technology at Odisha. So for audience, if you have any questions during the presentation, please send your questions on my WhatsApp number, that is 94297-01853. Again, I repeat my number, that is 94297-01853. Okay. So without any taking too much time, I will hand over today's session to Ramesh sir. Sir,
yes,
please continue.
Okay. So thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much. First of all, I'd like to congratulate all students of Parul University. So they are getting the opportunity to listen to us. Second, this session will promote innovation, incubations, student startups, the rhythms of research, new research, venturing research, no doubt. At earlier session with Parul University with engineering department, we explored few opportunities about my past innovations. Let me tell you, this side Professor Ramesh Panda, we are heading department of mechanical department and taking care of research wings, as well as working as assistant professor also here. I'm having 14 research patents. Few innovative research patents are there. Published few papers, research papers in Scopus and SCI journals, right? Out of my innovations, you can find sustainable clay cool refrigeration system, multi-chamber refrigeration system. You can find one my innovation on smart carbonless cooking gasifier. I devoted myself into sustainable practices. I'm venturing myself into Industry 4.0, IoT, artificial intelligence, and machine learning. Basically, what happens, in current pandemic situations, you can find we are losing million and million peoples, right? Which means what exactly happening? Peoples are suffering from COVID-19. So the educational groups and the researchers, the innovators, they are putting their effort best how to bring out new product, social impactful, low cost effective product to the market. Out of them you can find robotics, humanoid robot. You can find few engineers, few innovators, few scientists, they develop the concept of ventilator, cost-effective ventilators for intensive care units. You can find new ways of sanitizer dispenser machines. You can find the applications of remote sensing healthcare monitoring system, or you can say it is long distance healthcare monitoring system. And this situation also promoted us to learn about how to promote telemedicine. So this 2 and 3 months time, I invested best to develop some new technology, few new product, cost effective products, let me count it how I contributed. Number one, I developed one concept of 5G based optimized controlled humanoid robot with IoT based handheld ECG machine effective for intensive care units. This is my first innovation. I will explore about it. My second innovation is robotic process automated center shift ventilators that is also effective for your intensive care units. It is a cost effective ventilator where the general price lies between 3 lakhs to 15 lakhs rupees. You can find our product less than 10 to 15,000 rupees. Within that range, you can manufacture with same kind of features and better feasibility. We developed one mechanical ventilator. With the help of one of my friend, Dr. Navdeep from GNE University, we developed one concept and we prepared one machine, sanitizer dispenser machine. We found out the theory of how to find out COVID infectious from drain water coming from hospitals. Generally, what happens now when corona patients are admitting in hospitals, right? They're using toilet, bathroom, and washing basins, right? There may be existence of 6 to 7 days, there will be lives of COVID-19. So what are the detection method? We found out one way theory of exactly, not converted into product. Then tunnels, sanitizer tunnels, disinfectious sanitizer tunnel. With my team, with my mechanical HOD, Dr. UP Panigrahi here in Synergy Institute, and with the collaboration of student and faculty, we developed one sanitizer tunnel. I will show the photographs. So what exactly happened? This situation means compelled us, not compelled, motivated us to learn some new, to invent some new, to find out some sustainable practices, cost effectiveness of the product. And along with student and faculty of Synergy Institute of Engineering, we invested best for the research initiatives. So this is all about our, 2-3 months activities, and we published some few research paper on that also, and we filed some patent on intellectual property right of India. So let me tell you few of my early innovations so that it will motivate student and faculties definitely. One of my innovation was on, biotechnologies or medical wings. It is all about a social impactful project. One of my innovation on IoT based sustainable manufacturing of organic fertilizers, right? So what exactly we did that project? We bringing all the ingredient, naturally available ingredient, with by percentage of weight and mixing it, like your cow dung and urines, wastewater coming from your house, green leaves together, and mixing it in a central storing device, using a central storing device, right? Then allow to your cultivated land using pulsative pumps. It's a innovative, means not innovative, it's a sustainable practice innovations. Similarly, composting means generally what happens, the ready-made machines, conventional machines are available in market. The product composting machine price lies between 3 to 5 lakhs rupees. Same time we innovated this practice, in between 50,000 rupees, how we can convert the ready biodegradable wastage into green compost. So we used renewable source of energy, solar energy, wind energy, and converted it, right? So thing is, we have to continue such kind of practice. We have to motivate ourselves so that we can bring out some new sustainable cost-effective practices which will helpful for our society and motivate our youngsters, young generations. And the research, exactly. Research supposed to be compulsory, means for faculty, for student, we have to motivate our youngsters to learn some new, innovate some new, vent into new, right? So let me show few of my innovations, right? So this one is a ventilator designed by third year mechanical student of our Synergy Institute of Engineering and Technologies. The concept was developed by Dr. Navdeep from GNE University with one of my designer friend Dr. Sibasis. We developed this mechanism and we are going to patent Design Patent Act under intellectual property right. Please see this video.
So what exactly happening?
The conventional ventilators are available in market for intensive care units lies between 3 lakhs to 5 lakhs minimum price, and its price may be raised up to 15 lakhs depending upon the precisions. Price also raised up to 15 lakhs rupees. So instead of that, what we exactly did, using some mechanical and electronic arrangement and using some power transmission for bevel gears and some constant mechanisms, we developed this ventilator. It is one kind only. Actually, through this video I want to motivate my students, both mechanical engine, both Parul University and Synergy engineering student, that like this we can develop many more different mechanism related ventilators. Let me show you first few photographs so that you can able to understand few mechanisms. This mechanism is called quick return mechanisms. And this mechanism we are using for lathe machines also, right? What is the objective exactly? Our objective to press the balloon, right? For breathing purpose, we have to press the balloon. So what happened exactly? When this crank slotted lever cranks, it is rotating at 360 degree angle at the forward stroke and backward stroke. This pin, right? This what is that called? This link attached with the upper part, it will reciprocate in forward direction and backward direction. Basic principle behind ventilators, how to convert rotary motion into rectilinear motion. Many cost effective arrangement, mechanical power transmission or constant motion mechanisms we can apply to move the pistons or move the link in forward and backward direction to press the balloons. And with the help of simple digitalization and controlling unit, we can increase or decrease the rhythms of air pass outside. Let me show you another mechanisms. It is also converting your rotary motion into rectilinear motion. When this disc-like structure will rotate in clockwise direction, it will allow the upper link to move in forward and backward directions. When it will be move forward directions, it will press the balloon. When it will move backward directions, it will release the pressure, means it will again allow air inside the balloon. See these mechanisms also. You can optimize different parameter. You can optimize length of the mechanisms, length of the links. You can optimize the angle of rotation, you can optimize the rotation speed, and you can optimize the forward and backward stroke. What is the basic need of a ventilator? to press the balloon. So when you will move the link forward direction, it will press. And at what speed it will move and what speed it will back, right? It you can design with your own aids and you can carry out the process. You see this design, sun and planetary design. Usually when it will rotate, the piston inside the cylinder, it will move in forward and backward directions also. And you can press the balloon. This is another same design. It is animated. You can see this reciprocating motion, how, you know, this rotary motion of this multi-pinion can convert it to rectilinear motions of the rack. You can find it. These are the cost effective, means you can arrange with such kind of arrangement. You can avail the ventilators in between 5,000 to 10,000 for ready use for the old age or infant peoples admitted in for the in the intensive care unit. Main objective, how to convert rotary to linear, because generally what happens now, we are using DC motor, high torque, low speed DC motor for ventilators to rotate the discs in which we are generally fitting some links to move the, you see this arrangement. Same kind of principle you can implement. So let me tell you, you can see this mechanism. Very simple kind of mechanism, even if you can arrange within 1,000 rupees. Within 1,000 rupees, you can arrange the motor, you can arrange the slotted bars, you can arrange the rotors, right? You can optimize the process. Robotic automated process, you can optimize the process. You can lower the speed, you can higher the speed. We can maintain a constant motion as per your requirement for the manufacturing of ventilator. So through this, I want to promote my students to invest their best. Actually, this kind of things, second year and third year mechanical students are learning in their textbook of kinematic of machines, right? Whatever things they're learning, it is the right opportunity to convert into social impactful product. Ultimately, our education means how we can helpful for the society. And this is the right time to invest their best through hands-on learning, through practicing the common mechanisms are available. You cannot say it is an innovation. Actually, innovation means something new, something novel. Actually, when Britishers left our country, they confined the meaning of, you know, few words like this, we cannot go outside. We can't think about that words out of that meaning they already described. Innovation means something new, something, you know, what is that called? Something, you can say something, any kind of new development, modification in the product, more reliable. Right. We can bring some more reliability in existing product, that also we can say innovation, right? If you can develop the product life cycle in existing product, doing some little bit modification, that also can say as a innovation, right? So innovation is something, you know, thinking out of box, means something, you know, extraordinary. Something means bringing some newness, novelty, novel in the product, that is called innovations, bringing out some new, right? So using these mechanisms or converting this mechanism in costful way, right? Reduce the effectiveness, increasing the effectiveness, bringing more reliability in the product, improving more product life cycle, cost effectiveness, right? That you can say also innovations. So what are the new innovation means What are the new innovation thoughts or implement technologies we can adopt in common practices is your industry 4.0 linkage artificial intelligence without interrupt of human being, how we can operate the machine, how we can operate the things or mechanisms or any kind of utility product with the help of internet or a hand-free manner that is a part of IoT Internet of Things. How to predict the things that is a part of, you know, how to detect the things that is a part of your machine learning also. How to bring more sustainable approach using renewable source of energy. That is a part also. How to bring new communications, green communications, without hampering other sustainable approach or practices. That also part of new ways of innovations. How to bring, you know, that is called autonomous maintenance in the product. If suppose in some disorder happening, how machine can repair itself without interrupt of human being, that is also called innovation. I'm talking about some sustainable practices. These are the things we can implement to bring some new product or to modify the existing product, right? So I have written this article, you can read it. Yes, this is very interesting. I found it from Facebook today. And thanks to ma'am for motivating me. This is one of my friend, Mr. Nikhil Rathod. He developed one COVID solution sanitizer machines. This machine available at 4,000 to 5,000 rupees. With the help of my colleague, my friend from GN University, Dr. Navdeep sir, from mechanical department, they developed this portable ventilators. Cost in between lies between 4,000 to 5,000 only. It practicing the same, you know, same standard of reciprocating action, whatever existing ventilators are doing. CTTC Bhubaneswar, Central Tool Room Training Center, Bhubaneswar, they developed this mechanism using mechatronics. They automate the process and develop this ventilator. Designed for 840 respiratory rate. This is the earlier design we prepared for a mechanical ventilator. Price design in between 7,000 to 8,000 rupees. And we are going to file a patent against this design under IP India. This is the block diagram we designed. It's a theory of exactly how to find out COVID infectious drain water coming from hospitals. With the help of my friend, Dr. Sumit Ranjan from Power Coils, we both implemented our intellectual best and developed this two-side pressing ventilator. This product price coming in between 15,000 to 20,000 rupees, and it's completely digitalized. How we can go back? Hello.
On Vion side. Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, sir. On Vion side, you have to stop presenting.
Always
stop presenting.
Hello.
No. Just cancel it. Just cancel it.
Cancel. Then
backside. Go to backside, or just tap on upward. It shows Google Meet.
Okay. It's okay.
No, sir. Sir, it
should I disconnect and again connect?
No, sir. Sir, you can try it at once. Hello. Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. You can continue.
Okay. Now it's okay. Okay.
Yes. Okay. It's maybe network issue. Okay, you can start, sir.
What exactly I expect and try to motivate my students that open many different windows for learning approach. Not only for faculty, student can research from their subject matter, whatever the subject they are learning. For engineering and non-engineering student, they can invest bet on the theory of into product development. So that what will happen, what are the things they are learning in textbook, that will practicize through hands-on learning. And project-based learning is must. When you will practice project-based learning, student will see, realize, he will hold the things in hand, he will fabricate or assemble the thing, he can understand the mechanisms, right? So then after now, no need of read the textbook. That is the first benefit you will get. Second, during the manufacturing or assembly of product, he will get to know, let him know, means he will get to know what are the different requirements, you know, so that he will again research the things. And when you will research means it will, you will find opportunity to learn the things. And again, when you're developing few products, innovative products, there is huge opportunities market nowadays. In fact, in this era, you can find number of competitions are coming, number of hackathons are coming, number of, you know, call for proposals, student call for proposals are coming, idea competitions are coming. Government of India, government, state government, MSME of government of India, they are promoting students to present their idea. They are giving seed money to develop their projects also, right? And you can find online lecture, online webinar on technological inventions, how to reinvent the new technology, how to develop new product development, right? So plenty of opportunities are coming. So what I'm expecting exactly, number one, student must to open for hands-on learning, number one. Number two, project-based learning. Number three, more focus on practicals rather on theory. Our education, higher education supposed to be 30-70. Maximum limit supposed to be 40-60. 60-30% or 40% theory, and whatever things they are learning, they're supposed to be practicized through hands-on learning. It's supposed to be continue. Research must. They must have to search new idea. They have to go for, you know, open learning systems. Research reviews also required, right? And lastly, student opportunities means they must have to avail with respect to this project development in new innovations, right? Government of India and state government MSME, more than 40 MSMEs are there. They are open up to 15 lakhs funding for students. Up to 15 lakhs funding. At each equal 3 months intervals, MSME open for 15 lakhs funding for students. They are providing that much seed monies. More than 28,000 engineering colleges, private universities are there. All engineering universities, they are having own incubation centers. Even if you are Parul University, they must have incubation center. Student must be promoted. Student must motivate to apply to MSME through your incubation system. Right? So, innovation means, I am telling you, maybe students means they are in student stage, they are not able to understand, but exactly I found from internet many students, they innovated many new idea on ventilators, sanitizers, right? They innovated concept for how to find out COVID infectious using machine learning, tracing and distressing the temperatures, right? Student can do that. Nowadays, everything available online, they can go through online portals, right? They can download the manuals with video lectures. They can surf open learning system like your initiatives of, your Swayam Prabha, right? They are opening plenty of opportunities. So student must avail it. And last time I interacted a few Parul University student, and after webinar, I interacted with the engineering student of our Synergy Institute. They found very interesting. And in between these 3 months time, they put a lot effort best to innovate, many plenty of things. In between, I'm telling you, 6 months, 7 months time, we innovated more than 10 to 15 numbers of new products. Students of Synergy Institute, they filed patent, publishing research paper in different conference. Same thing I'm expecting from your students also. Let avail the opportunities, explore you best, right? And try to develop one learning atmosphere around yourself. Motivate yourself, motivate your friends, right? So that you can get some better prosperity in the future. Ma'am. Hello. Hello.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
What more expecting from me?
Yes. Sir, there is no patience from audience side, but if you want to give some idea related to innovation, like how to do innovation in existing product,
yes,
then you can share it.
Okay. Let me tell you, before 2 days, we have started one project under guidance of our HOD Mechanical Department, Dr. U.P. Paningrai sir. We did one project for, disinfectious sanitizer tunnel using one DC motor on some fog nozzles, right? With one mechanical structure, we developed, started the project, right? Let me show you. If I'm having that photographs, again, I won't return back. If I return back, means it will create problems for me.
Yes, sir, no issue.
Okay. That's okay. Can you see my screen?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes. See this sanitizer tunnel, please. The white shirt wearing person is my HOD, Professor U.P. Paningrai, sir. Under his guidance, we have started. So, it's the idea already available in market. You can surf internet, you can find the things. But nowadays, we are thinking of how to reinvent the things, how to bring some sustainable approach. You can see this project is fitted with a motor. This motor is not visible in this diagram, in this figure. To run the motor, we need electricity, right? This idea already existed in market. To run the motor, DC motor, we need electricity. So how to avail that electricity? Using solar energy or wind energy, renewable source of energy. That will be one innovations. Now this machine is manually operated. If suppose we'll implement some idea, I'm talking about, you know, how to bring innovation in existing product, not newly developed product, on existing product. Suppose we are using this machine manually, innovation may be how to make the things hand-free using IoT or mobile captcha or web assistance, right? How we can bring the things. Number three, you can see when the sanitizers are falling from the, you know, from the nozzle, fog nozzle, it's going to waste. We cannot reuse it. Innovation can bring, we can bring the innovation, how to recycle or reuse the wasted sanitizer coming from the nozzle. These are the three different way we can bring some newness in the product. Okay. Any other question, please?
Sir, just give idea related to patent.
Yes. See, I started my innovation means started my projects. Innovation means for patents before 1.5 years back. Let me tell you, the patents are going to file under Intellectual Property Right of India, right? I am associated with Calcutta Patent Office. For every patent, you have to bring some, suppose you develop one new concept or new idea, new product development with their own design, patent outcome, and utility, right? Let me tell you, first of all, before filing patent, you have to arrange the search report. Search report something means you have to find out whether the existing product you develop, the product you develop, whether it's exist in market or not. With respect to worldwide innovation, it will bring a report for you. Then after, what you have to do, you have to prepare one against draft, against the source report. Means how your product or innovation different from the exist products or existing innovations. After that, we have to prepare the art of literature, prior art of literature. What is the exact motivations you are getting, where you got the idea? Then your abstract, you have to define what exactly all about this product and what is the outcome, not more than 500 words. Then you have to give the descriptions with the diagrams, well illustrated diagrams or well demonstrated diagrams. Then you have to define the number of claims. That's very important for patent. Number of claims supposed to match with the body of the patent literature. If it is not match, means during the patent examination, you might find some difficulties, right? So number of claims, not with respect to theorem of the product or project you are developing or innovations you are doing, right? It's with respect to practicality, means after development of project, what's supposed to be the expected outcomes? It's supposed to be the claim, declare as the claims. 90% utility patent fail because the claims are not exactly, you know, represented. Suppose you are filing a patent with respect to your theorem, but during the examination, they want to visualize your product. When theory converted to practicals, means there may be some, you know, 36 difference will be there. So that time the number of claims you already defined during the theory of time may not match at the practical after execution of the projects. So your number of claims supposed to be very defined with respect to exact innovation, exact assemble parts for manufacture of the project, right? Then you have to, you can file the patent by yourself or you can hire an attorney. Those are registered attorney, you can hire them, right? It will take minimum 25 to 30 months time for patent grant. Patent publication is not big thing. How you are contesting and how you are ready prepared for the patent questionnaires coming during the examination, that's very important. And patent is very, very worthy. It's not a qualification, but it's a worthy outcome. Worthy outcome of faculties, student also. One patent publication itself carries the value more than 10 times ACI Index Journal, right? So, what exactly I want to tell you means you have to motivate your student. You can bring some new idea or whatever existing projects available with your labs, right? Or earlier project available with your institute. Engage your students to modify or bring some more reliability in the product, right? And how can you reduce the price, cost of the product? That is very important thing. Research not all about, to write some, literature review or doing some analytic studies or publishing some papers. This is not called research. Publications with my, means this is my thought process, that publications, citations, H index, I index, right? Your impact factor, these are the motivations. They're promoting us to learn some new. But the actual practice of research, how you can help the society, how you can bring some new product development, impactful product development, which will be more useful for the society, number one. How you can reduce the cost of the price, product, not price, cost of the product. That is the vital part of a research. Means, suppose something available at 10 rupees, how you can bring the product price to 5 rupees so it will be available by, everybody. Cost reduction. More durability in the product. What supposed we do so that the product life cycle will be improved? It will be more reliable for the customer or end users, right? And how it will be social impactful? The year 2020, it's a big year for me. I'm telling you very frankly. From the day one, I have decided I will invest myself in, sustainable practice. And fortunately, I developed few product, innovative product. I applied under different ministries for, fundings. So this is the actually way we have to invest, how we can convert our learning process into product development. So it will produce opportunity of again new learning process, right? So patents actually two types. One is utility patent, second one is your design patent, right? Using any softwares like your CATIA and PROE or analysis tool, you can design and analysis the product, and you can submit under design Design Act, Intellectual Property Right of India. Or if you are having any utility product or any product development, innovative, feasible product development, you can file as a utility patent under your IPR cell, Government of India. For design patent, it takes maximum 11 to 15 months. But for utility patent, it takes minimum 25 to 30 months. Ma'am.
Sir, one question from student. How do you know idea is based for filing a patent?
Sorry? Yeah, tell me, ma'am.
How do you know that our idea is based for filing a patent?
Yes. That you can get from source report. Actually, this registered portal available with patent agents, right? You can get the details from there. Source report, it is number of innovation already made and exact innovation available, everything by keywords, right? Actually, few innovations are there. They are not listed with, with search engines. But if it is available, means anyhow you have to do the modifications. Source report is the best idea to know whether the product available or not. Yes, ma'am. Any more
okay.
questions?
Sir, if you want to share that student.
Yes, ma'am.
If you want to share something with our students, you can.
Your voice is not audible, ma'am, clearly. Hello.
Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Hello. I'm audible?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, yes.
Sir, I'm saying if you want to, if you say something that is beneficial for our students, then you can say that, sir.
No, that I'm told you, na. First of all, you motivate your student for, you know, hands-on learning, number one. Number two, you motivate them for, you know, for project work. Whatever theory you guys are teaching through hands-on learning and practical exploration supposed to be more. Number three, motivate student for research work, right? Number four, try to make them, try to motivate them how to align with social problems, right? These are the things I like to advise. And more focus for the future,
okay,
obviously, new opportunities,
okay,
new learning opportunities.
Okay, sir. Thank you,
okay,
sir.
Mostly.
Thank you so much. Okay. And thank you, everyone. We appreciate you being here. Thanks to Parul University for giving me an opportunity to host such kind of webinar. Thank you so much, sir.
Welcome.
For webinar. Thanks again for joining us today. We will see you next time. Thank you.